Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Open Mic Night live at the Zoom Bar DC. We've got a great show for you tonight. We've got Bill Sherman, Joseph Stegner, and Marie-Louise Murville, and more. So sit back, relax, have a great time, and Bill Sherman's going to kick us off. Take it away, Bill.
Hi, everybody. So I'm going to do two songs in one. Okay. Reminds me of an old commercial, but I'm not quite sure what it was. It wasn't Double Mint Gum. That was Double Your Pleasure, Double Your Fun with Double Mint, Double Mint, Double Mint Gum. Anyway, and I'm going to do the blues. Now, if Dave Sherman said that, nobody would think that was strange, but I don't always do the blues. Every day, every day I've got the blues, every day. Every day I've got the blues, yeah. When you see me worried, baby, well, it's you I'd hate to lose. Nobody loves me, nobody seems to care, well, nobody loves me, nobody seems to care. I'm talking about worried and bad luck, mama. Well, you know I've had my share. Every day, every day, every day, every day, every day, baby. Every day I've got the blues. When you see me worried, baby, well, it's you I'd hate to lose. I'm gonna pack up my suitcase, I'm gonna move it on down the line. I'm gonna pack up my suitcase, yeah, I'm gonna move it on down the line. Where the show ain't nobody worried, and there ain't nobody crying. Every day, every day, every day, every day, and every day, every day, every day I've got the blues, yeah. When you see me worried, baby, well, it's you I'd hate to lose. When you see me worried, baby, well, it's you I'd hate to lose. When you see me worried, baby, well, it's you I'd hate to lose. Further on up the road, somebody's gonna hurt you like you're hurting me. Further on up that road, somebody's gonna hurt you like you hurt me. Talking about worried and bad luck, baby, well, you know I've had my share. You got to reap just what you sow. It's just like that good book said, mama. You got to reap just what you sow. And you have it further down the road. I'm having trouble remembering it. Further on up the road, somebody's gonna hurt you like you're hurting me. Further on up that road, somebody's gonna hurt you like you're hurting me. Further on up the road, baby, just you wait and see. You be laughing pretty, baby, But someday you'll be crying. You'll be laughing, pretty baby. But someday you'll be crying. Further on up that road, you're gonna see I wasn't lying. Further on up the road, somebody's gonna hurt you like you're hurting me. Further on up the road, somebody's gonna hurt you like you hurt me. Further up that road, baby, just you wait and see. Someday you're gonna want me back, 'cause you'll be sad and blue. You're gonna want me back, honey, 'cause you'll be sad and blue. But when that day comes, you find out I got someone new. So further on up the road, somebody's gonna hurt you like you're hurting me. Further on up that road, baby, somebody's gonna hurt you like you're hurting me. Further on up the road, just you wait and see. Further on up the road, just you wait and see. Further on up the road, just you wait and see. See, and that was two.
Oh!
One. Yeah.
Two songs in one.
Excellent.
For all that minty freshness.
Not bad for forgetting it part.
Yeah, no, that was great. Yay, Bill.
Yay.
I think that the two mints in one is the double mint thing. I think they had several good ads.
Yeah, that's true. They did. I remember when they had twin girls and twin boys, and yeah. Double your pleasure, double your fun with double mint, double mint, double mint gum. Yeah.
Okay.
Maybe it was Clorets.
Clorets. Wow.
Clorets are two mints in one. I know they push two round packages together. Clorets, yeah. I don't know.
I like old commercials.
A candy for your pleasure and a breath mint with the chlorophyll. Something like
oh,
that.
Oh, I think you're right. Yeah.
I'm not as confident as you are, but I appreciate it.
I think you're right. I think you're right.
Okay.
Okay, I'm gonna. Now I'm
Marie-Louise.
Next song, and I'm gonna. If the sound is terrible, please stop me and I'll try something else. I mean, if I don't hear anything, I'll assume it's okay. Okay. Your party's jumping, everybody's having a good time, and you know what's going through my mind. Do you mind if I get comfortable and kick off these shoes while you're fixing me a drink? Play me some of them down home. You know, I don't get out much on the town. And you know, I got cut out a lot of that running around all week long. I've been keeping my cool, wanna hear is some down home blues all night long. Every other record or two. Take on those fast jams and let me hear some down home blues. All right. Oh, my old man, gonna wanna fight. Because of the hour, I'll be getting home tonight, but I don't care. Tonight I'm gonna do as I choose. Gonna get my head back and party off these down home blues. Down home blues. Down home blues. All I wanna hear is some down home blues all night long. Every other record or two. Get my hand back and party off the down home. Down on blues. Down on blues.
Yeah. Definitely.
Down home blues. Excellent.
Was the audio okay?
Yeah.
Yes.
Perfectly balanced.
Yay!
Which is what I remember the last time, 2 weeks ago.
Oh, really? It was the same last time?
Yeah. I think maybe it came out different on the recording, but live, yeah.
Oh, okay.
And you were having fun, too, and that's really what's important.
Oh, good.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you.
thank you.
Okay, up next we've got Joseph.
All right, well, I'm not pretending to be musical this week. I haven't had any time to add practice on the guitar, so I'm just going to stick to poetry with what's going on in the world. The lyrics are where I'm at. So this one is in response to... Well, I'll let it speak for itself. It's called Proud Enemy of Education, Ron DeSantis Spews His Gas. Pretending details aren't important, his understanding is as bleak, unaware of all his ignorance that he's not ashamed to speak. Emboldened by his office and the power which he wields, his arrogance makes him foolish, despite how proud he feels. Finding the area of circles and squares should be sufficient in itself. Trigonometry and calculus should be banned from the eye and the shelf. Of course, that is hyperbole. He wouldn't say such thing. But when it comes to history, it's that curse he chooses to bring. Keep his subjects stupid so they think that they are smart, and he can sculpt the hearts of children like a sorcerer for his art. The art of a deal with deception, so he can lie about what bias brings as he tries to reinvent the wheel with the square shape that he brings. Oh, how the bullies love him, the feckless and the fake, who will tickle the ear and pocket for what their fallen souls will take. Observantly, friend of a teacher who fled his folly. I wrote that in January 24th, 2023. Ron DeSantis spews his gas, proud enemy of education. Okay, that's number one.
Well, I first of all, Do you think if I walked up to him and said, what's pi r squared, he'd say, hey, look, I'm not square and I'm not going to eat the pie. I'm not feeling like eating pie right now. You think he would know what the area of a circle is?
No, I have no idea. I don't know. But I think I like that one because I think it's well-written for its description and its imagery.
It's succinct and to the point. I like it.
And unfortunately, that's kind of the vocation of a poet, is to observe what's going on and respond accordingly. The following poem I wrote 2 years ago on January 6th of 2020. No, I think I wrote this one. Well, it says here January 6th, 2021, but I think it might have been 2022 and I just didn't change the date yet. It's called Grand Old Party, Hijacked by Groupies of Perdition. A plane can leave its origin with destination all mapped out, but hijackers have their own agenda and will toss that directive out. Likewise, in society, groups can be commandeered, wherein pollution is accepted and from its charter veered. Today, we witness the same in a country long esteemed as the ultimate in democracy with liberty its dream. Now, for selfish reasons, groupies show their face to be anti-heroes of humanity to steal a higher place. Faces of corruption like Jordan, Cruz, and Trump boast within their arrogance their heads aren't in their rump. Selectively blind to the dangers of the short-term gain they seek, into the lair of evil they are willing to more than peek. Doublespeak lies and dismissal are their favorite go-to friends. In the power of seduction, the fallen soul pretends. Inversion of perspective to display what team they're on, the undead cannot recognize their reflection as the con. Undead seems unfair to say, but I think it really fits to describe the spineless and souled who can't tell where their wretched ass sits. Find suits and fragrant cologne, they conceal the smell of their crap. So I used another word, but I shouldn't have changed it because then it doesn't rhyme. They conceal the smell of their bleep, confusing opulence for holiness and heaven for flames of the pit. Inversion is a real thing, like the serpent to Adam and Eve, infecting the perception until falsehood is believed. History reveals what becomes of prophets who rebuke egocentric hands, but that's what separates us from those showing fealty to unholy demands. My place in the gallows, should the wicked have such day, to say that good is bad and for evil we must play. We were told to love even enemies if heaven is our goal. Why follow who has fallen if you love your sacred soul? Sheep will know their shepherd, and some prefer predator pay, so they do whatever it takes to make others become prey. We can tell a tree by its fruit and the sinful by whom they salute. The selfish don't care who gets sick when rivers they pollute. We are at an antebellum time where sloth is tempting blood, made possible by deception that a creep is more the stud. The grand old party has been hijacked by groupies of perdition who say it's patriotic to surrender to sedition. Observantly, a thorn in the shoe of the proud. It says January 6, 2021, but I'm pretty sure that I think I made a mistake on that. There's our second poem.
Why do you think that it's not 2021? Are you talking about...
Because that was the day of the insurrection, and I don't believe... Yeah, and I don't think I wrote it on that same day, and so I think it's possible that I wrote it
a year later.
Yeah, it's possible I wrote it in 2022, so still makes it over a year old. But
hey, Joseph,
I like the cadence of both the first and the second one. Very succinct, which is not, it's different than what you usually do.
Thank you.
I liked it. I really did. Thank you. And the second one was funny in a lot of ways, too.
Thanks.
Yay, Joseph. Okay. Bill, you want to do some more songs?
Let me see here. Let me see what I can pull out of my rump. That was a nod to you, Joseph. Rump.
Thank you.
I can't say that I hear the word rump very often.
Yeah, it's not too often.
So for those of you that might know Gant Kushner, he often notes that he's going to he's going to record an album called Songs in the Key of A. Well, tonight I'm doing Songs in the Key of E. So if it sounds a lot like the first two, it's because it's in the key of E. You gotta help me. Can't do it all by myself. You gotta help me, honey. Can't do it all by myself. And if you won't help me, baby, I'm gonna find somebody else. When I walk, you walk with me. And when I talk, you gotta talk with me, honey. Baby, can't do it all by myself. And if you don't help me, honey, I gotta find somebody else. I might wash, and I might sew. I might cook, you know, I might even mop your floor. But you gotta help me, woman. Can't do it all by myself. And if you won't help me, baby, I gotta find somebody else. Bring me my nightshirt, put on your morning gown, baby. Well, bring me my nightshirt and put on your morning gown. I ain't sleepy or tired, honey. I just feel like lying down. You know what I'm talking about? I ain't sleepy or tired, mama. I just feel like lying down. I ain't sleepy or tired, honey. I just feel like lying down. Now, the first time I heard that song was, back in the, and believe me, they didn't write it. I don't even know who did write it, but in the late 70s, mid-70s, the Nighthawks album, I forget the title of it, but the cover of it is a parody or a takeoff on that Chicago painting of a guy in a coffee shop. It was Art Deco like, but I don't remember the name of the album. Anyway, let me see. I've been beat by the wind, chased by the snow, had my head stoved in, and don't you know that I'm still willing. Driving the road late at night, I see my pretty Alice facing every headlight. I said, Alice, whoa, Dallas, Alice. And I've been from Tucson to Tucumcari, from Hatcha Peak to John of Paul. I've driven every kind of rig that's ever been made. I've driven in the back roads so I wouldn't get weighed. And if you give me weed, white sand wine, and you show me a sign, and I'll I've been beat by the wind, robbed by the sleet, had my head stoved in, but I'm still on my feet, and I'm still in a whole lot of trouble. I smuggled some smokes and folks from Mexico, baked by the sun every time I go to Mexico. And I'm still, and I've been from Tucson to Tucumcari, from Hatcher Peak to John Paul, driven every kind of rig that's ever been made. Drive them in the back road so I wouldn't get weighed. And if you give me weed, white sand wine, and you show me a sign, I'll be willing to be moving. I'll be willing to be moving on. I know you always liked that song,
Marie. Thank you, Bill.
Sure.
Love that song. Okay. So, anybody want to tell more poems or stories or sing more?
I got you ready.
Okay.
They're short and they're poet related as far as their topic. This one's called Honey Badger Poet. A defining moment in my life came when I was 10 years old. I ran to a neighbor for help when my dad was drowning my mother by her hair in his cold. I was crying and pleading as a man watched it all. I don't want to get involved. I don't want to get involved, became my antithetical call. Dang it, I gotta slow down. My heart's racing. Honey Badger Poet, I'm starting again. A defining moment in my life came when I was 10 years old. I ran to a neighbor for help when my dad was drowning my mother by her hair in his hold. I was crying and pleading as a man watched it all. I don't want to get involved, became my antithetical call. I stood there with instant disbelief, pausing my soul to observe the kind of person I vowed not to be. I was appalled by his apathy of nerve. Years later, I would become a medic and saw my share of pain, which makes me ferocious in lyric when malignant intent puts its hand on a rein. So this next one is very similar. It's called Blood, Tears, and Ink. What leads to the things we think? What determines the path of our thought? What makes the heart of some on some obsession caught? One that won't relent through any hour of day and cannot be forsaken even through the act of play? For me, it's pretty simple. Percussions made their mark. The gunshot wounds and trauma haunt with images stark. I need not imagine the ending of life or how it looks in its fact when the body has been opened by mortal wounds of attack. Such is the truth for first responders who are called to respond to the need to employ the tools of rescue when others were used to make bleed. It's game on for the medic who doesn't want to simply wait to observe what is foreseeable and preventable for a state. Apathy is an enemy, yet seductive it can be when the human heart is influenced to open up that gate. Ride we do upon steeds of choice to neutralize embers of hate when flames from falsehood strike parched souls to make destruction a mate. There you go.
There you go.
Very nice, Joseph.
Again,
thank you.
Like what you did hear this evening, they're succinct. They're, you know, I think sometimes less is more.
Yeah, I told that a lot. Which is why I tried to shorten them to music, and been trying to to evolve for all of you. But yeah, so thanks.
Well, thank you.
Thanks, Joseph.
I have one more.
Yay.
Yep, I have one more. And then I would have to, anything else I would have to like look up and practice. You call to tell me you were lonely. Sorry. You call to tell me you were lonely. You cried the whole night through. Well, you can cry me a river. Cry me a river. 'Cause I cried a river over you. Then you said you were lonely, you were sorry for being so untrue. Well, go on and cry me a river, cry me a river, 'cause I cried a river over you. You drove me nearly, drove me out of my mind. And you never shed a tear. Remember, I remember all that you said. You said that love was too plebeian and you were through with me. And now you tell me that you love me. Well, even if that's true, I want you to cry me a river. Cry me a river. 'Cause I cried a river over you. It's true, I cried a river over you. I want you to cry me a river, 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 cry me a river. 'Cause I cried a river over you. Thank you.
Woohoo!
Thank you.
Okay. Well, I think that's our show for tonight. Thanks, everybody, for another great open mic night.
Yeah. I enjoyed being able to open up a little bit more than usual.
Okay. Thanks, everybody, and we'll see you next week.
See you next week. Love y'all.
Thanks, Bill. Thanks, Joseph. Thank you. Thanks, Marcia.
Love you all, too.
Thanks, Dave.
Thank you,
Marcia. Bye for now. Thank you, everybody.
Bye.
Marcia.
Good night.
And Bill, have a great week.
You too. Bye.